In this Binance tutorial, I will show you how to deposit fiat currencies like dollars, pounds, or euros into your Binance account, but also how to deposit your cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin into your Binance account as well. So if you need to transfer some funds from another wallet or exchange, then I've also got you covered here. And as a bonus, towards the end of this video, I will show you how to earn some passive income using your Binance account. So make sure to stick with me to the end. But for now, let's get started. First, click on the link in the description or type this into your browser. It'll take you to the correct Binance sign-up page to get you started if you don't have an account yet. And if you want more information on the actual sign-up process and the verification steps, then I have a tutorial video which I'll link in the description for you. So now to deposit your fiat or cryptocurrency into Binance, from your homepage, you would go to Wallet, then click on Overview. This will take you to a summary page where it will show you the total amount of asset of both fiat and crypto that you have on your account. And to deposit, you simply just click on this button here. The two main ways of depositing into Binance is through crypto or cash. So I'll show you the crypto method first and we'll just click here. This will take you to the deposit page. Quick note is, if you want to deposit fiat, you can just click on this button here, which I'll show you in a few moments. But now I'll run you through the crypto deposit method first. So from the top, you can see the coin here selected that you want to deposit. If you want to deposit something else, like Ethereum, then you can click here and type in ETH for Ethereum here, or a different currency like Cardano, or any other currency that you wish. But for this example, we just choose Bitcoin. Now moving over to the right, you can see the different blockchains that Binance supports. So first of all, BTC is on the left, and then you have the two Binance chains here, and followed by the ERC20, which is an Ethereum blockchain. So it's very important to get this exactly right, so the address is correct. So obviously with BTC here, you're only gonna have the BTC option or BTC SegWit. So make sure you don't select the wrong blockchain. And if, for example, you wanna select Ethereum, then you wanna make sure ERC20 is clicked so that it gives you the correct address for that blockchain. It's absolutely vital that you use the correct blockchain and the exact address copied. So you can click here to copy your address. If you don't do this and miss out on a letter or use the wrong blockchain, your funds that you want to deposit may be lost forever. Now, if you're using an exchange or a mobile app and you want to just scan this code, then you can just hover over here and scan the barcode to copy this address as well. So now I'm going to show you an example of where you would put this address. So we just click on copy. And right here, I'm simply using my KuCoin account as an example. So once I select BTC to withdraw, then in this wallet address section, I would just click here and simply paste in my address, which I copied from Binance, put in the amount and then confirm. And it's that simple. And one quick tip is I always make sure to check that the first two or three letters and the last two or three is the same. So here's 13RE and I just double check 13RE and then I press confirm. Another thing to note is that when you're transferring cryptos from one account to another, there will always be a fee. Some may be higher, some may be smaller, but there will be some sort of fee involved. So just make sure you have accounted for that. Here's a quick question for you. What percentage of your portfolio do you plan on holding in Bitcoin and why? Let me know in the comments section below. Okay, I think that's enough with the crypto depositing. Let's go to depositing fiat now. And you can just click on this button here at the top right hand side. And this will take you to the fiat depositing page. And firstly, you can select your currency that you want. So you can do Australian dollars, euro, British pounds, or even US dollars. So I'll select USD for now by typing it in and clicking here. And you can see here, Binance is very good as most of their fiat currencies that you deposit will have zero fees. So that's a very handy thing to have. Once you're happy with that, then you can click on continue. And now you can see that you have to verify your account first if you want to deposit any fiat currency into your Binance account. You don't need to with the first method like I mentioned by depositing crypto, but with fiat you have to. But the steps are very easy and it'll only take you a couple minutes. So all you do is click on verify now. Now we pick a residential country here and click on verify now. Put your personal information in and there it is. My account has been verified to the basic level. But you can see here, depending on what country you're from, different levels allow you to buy a different amount of crypto. So for example, with this one, if you're just on the basic, you're only allowed to buy $300 lifetime. So if you want any more than that, you'll need to verify to the next level. But to verify, you will require to have either your passport or ID card, a picture of you, and also facial verification.
Do you like the level of detail I'm providing you in my Binance tutorial so far?
If yes, make sure to let me know by liking my video and don't forget to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on quality content that I'll be releasing every single week. So now that our account has been verified, you can click on continue and it will take you to the next step where you can enter in the amount that you want to deposit. In this example, I just put in 1,000, click continue again. Now you must make sure that the bank account that you're using to transfer into Binance is in your exact name. Otherwise Binance will not accept it. And also the reference code must match. Now we can click on confirm and it will take you to this page where you'll have to then log into your bank account to make this transfer by copying the exact account name, numbers and reference codes here. And I suggest you click here one by one and copy and paste it into your transfer through your bank account. Now, just a quick note that if you're depositing US dollars, it's going to automatically change that into BUSD, which is called Binance US dollar, but is still pegged one for one to the US dollar. But I'm just telling you this so that you can find it later. Make sure to type in BUSD to find the amount that you deposited in. Next thing I want to let you know is that this transfer is going to take between 2 to 4 business days, just like any other bank transfers would. So this is where purchasing your crypto with your credit card is going to be much quicker, but obviously the fees are going to be much higher. So I'm guessing this is why you want to learn how to deposit fiat through your bank transfer. And now once your funds have arrived into your Binance account, you're ready to go and purchase your crypto and start trading. And there are two ways of doing this, and that is to go to your trade and click on convert or go to advanced if you want to trade more rigorously. And I have a step-by-step tutorial guiding you on this here. So check that out if you want more information on this step. So the next thing I want to show you about Binance is the Binance Earn program. So this is a really cool way that you can earn some free interest on the cryptocurrency that you're currently holding on Binance. So it's kind of like a bank savings account, but for cryptocurrencies. So we want to go to finance and click on Binance Earn. So you can see here, if we scroll down straight away, there's a lot of different products that Binance have, like the BNB vaults, normal staking, fixed term savings, and flexible savings. I won't go through each of these in details right now, but I have a fully dedicated video here, which guides you through all of this Binance Earn step by step. So check that out if you want more information. But let's go down and take a look at one of them here. So I'm just gonna pick the savings one for now, click on view more, and it will take me to my Binance savings page where you can see that they are flexible and locked savings where you can transfer your funds into these pools to start earning interest. For example, if we have some BUSD and we want to earn some interest on that, by going to the flexible savings option, you'll get a 2.19% APY. But if we go down to the locked savings, then you're going to earn 5.31% APY. So you can see by locking your assets for a certain amount of time, you're going to earn more interest. So if I go to 14 days, it's even more, 30 and 90 can go up to as high as 6%. So that is a worthwhile thing to do, I believe, especially if you're holding your crypto assets on Binance. But if you're not going to make use of this Binance Earn, then I recommend you transfer all your crypto into your own crypto wallet, as this will be the safest way of storing your cryptocurrency. So if you're ready to proceed with Binance and want to learn more about the next step you should take, then I recommend you watch this next video here. But if you think the Binance exchange is not the right one for you, then this is the best exchange alternative, which I recommend. So check them out and I'll see you in the next tutorial.